This thing isn't going to catch it. He has a camera right there that he's able to zoom in on people. I'd recommend that he do that instead of doing what we did last week.
Go ahead, Sherry.
I'm here to talk about a failure in leadership. It's been about a year, a little over a year, since Richard Lockhart came to Lawrence. He name-dropped this book when he came to town. It's called Police Accountability, The Role of Citizen Oversight, written by Samuel Walker. He's a recognized expert when it comes to police oversight. I don't know that Rich has actually read this book, because it keys on oversight. And I bring up oversight because the last CPRB meeting was canceled, but in that meeting he was about to bring more reports that are inadequate, that have been published before complainants have been contacted. The PC 22-129 in the CPRB minutes that you'll see, or I hope you'll review, was a bias complaint that I made standing at this podium. The last thing I'm going to do is I'm pushing send on an email that comes to all of you, including the chief of police, and it's a bias complaint because that jaywalking ticket, the only one issued this year to a homeless person, was straight up bias. And I hope you all remember it. That bias complaint has been closed, just simply closed. It was the only jaywalking ticket that was given in this city in 2022, given to a homeless person who couldn't afford to pay. I've demanded that that be escalated to the CPRB to give them something to do, and I've also demanded an explanation. Richard Lockhart is employed by the city of Lawrence, a city in which I've resided for more than 30 years before he was hired and moved here. I am a taxpayer and the citizen who made the bias complaint that was referenced. Not only was there no inquiry with me for any further information about the bias complaint or the allegation, this complaint has reached resolution, if you want to call it that, meaning that it was closed, which is not one of the options listed at the bottom of the complaint report. Now that complainant, me, a taxpaying citizen, is asking for an answer to how that could be reported without me receiving any contact, and I am not hearing anything back. Rich Lockhart sent me a letter last month after I called out his December problems. Additionally, I want to apologize to you for not getting this letter to you before the complaint outcome was reported to the CPRB. This was an error on our part, and we will be working to improve the process. Where's that work happening? In this book that Rich Lockhart so eloquently name-dropped, but I don't think read, on page 4 you'll find a paragraph that talks about 3 departments that had issues. In all of these departments, the guilty officers apparently felt reasonably sure that they would not be reported by their fellow officers and never be disciplined by their departments. The problem of police misconduct, in short, is not a few bad officers, but dysfunctional police departments where accountability mechanisms have either broken down or never existed in the first place. I want to tell you right now that that paragraph and Rich Lockhart's recommendation is why I've been in front of you for more than a year now.
Thank you, Michael.
It's your problem to fix.
Next, general public.
Just, I was looking at what's coming on today's agenda, and I noticed that y'all aren't appointing anyone to the Community Police Review Board again. It just seems crazy if we have vacancies.
Chris, that's an item that's on the agenda, so if
so
you
I, could. I'll, I guess I'll pull it.
Thank you.
Jeremy Roth Cushell. I wanted to deal with the framework in terms of the agenda items that you're going to be dealing with today, which in many ways have to do with good democratic moves, revitalizing a democracy in the city, both economically but also politically. And in that vein, I want to remind the commission that after you re-establish the general public comment, it became that you have to comment on something that's germane to the business of the commission. And I just want to remind the commission that the business of the commission is first and foremost the of, by, and for we the people. the business of we the people and our democracy. There's also business of business, but the commission needs to make sure that it doesn't see itself as just some kind of electorally graced homeowners association. And in that vein, I would like to remind the mayor that I've seen, as I've been, I haven't had time to come down in person, but I've been trying to pay attention to the meetings, and I've noticed that you've referred to this assembly of people, we the people, you could call us members of the public, as the audience. This is not a theater performance. This is not a TV show. There is theater involved in this. There you perform your responsibilities. But this is an assembly. This is protected under the First Amendment. And so I would urge you and ask you to refer to us as the public, the people, those in the assembly, when you're calling for our comment in the future. And in general, I think we need to really widen the scope of how we might want to make our democratic input in this city more vigorous. Thank you.
Items on the consent agenda are considered under one motion and approved by one motion. There will be no separate discussion on these items. If discussion is desired, that item will be removed from the consent agenda and considered separately. Members of the public wishing to speak on an item that has been pulled off the consent agenda will be limited to 3 minutes for comments. Are there any items that commissioners want to pull off?
Chris.
Right. How about members of the audience?
D4.
Member of the public, D1A.
Was D4A the...
D4 is the appointment.
Okay. Anybody on Zoom? Opposed to, passes 5-0. We're going to D4A,
receive appointments.
Before I go into talking about this appointment, I'd like to point out that this appointment, if you guys have gone online, because they don't print it out here, that this appointment is for the Housing Board. It doesn't have anything to do with the CPRB, which is what Chris was about to address during his public comment. So I'm going to demand right now that the mayor stop this meeting and allow Chris to have his 3 minutes of public comment, and then we continue this.
Your time is right now, Michael.
My time is right now, so I assume Chris is just going to be shut down and not given his 3 minutes to speak?
No, he'll get back.
Is he going to be given 6 minutes to speak? Because we've got a housing authority appointment here. This is not CPRB. It should be CPRB because members are dropping like flies, and I wonder why that is. Could it be the control of the police department being exerted on them? What is it? Lockhart comes in here and controls that meeting. Refuses to allow them to go into executive sessions. Refuses Minor the opportunity to control his own meeting. Lockhart brings bullshit reports into the CPRB, but you guys can't appoint members. And I know that you have applications. I know that you have untouchable applications that you refuse to even look at. Those voices are needed in the room. Those voices are desperately needed in that room because you're getting one side of the narrative. One side of the narrative is what causes stories in newspapers like what we've seen over the weekend. One-sided narratives is what you're getting at the CPRB. How about we start appointing some members that don't just automatically buy into the BS that Lockhart spins? How about we appoint some members that will actually start asking the questions and pushing the board toward the authority they talk about that they want? Whatever happened to the idea that we were going to expand that to cover more complaints? What happened? Lockhart started voluntarily bringing in his version of a complaint report that we were just supposed to accept and not talk about that anymore.
A lot of these things, I think, is just a part of us telling our story better.
But his version of a complaint report does lack quite a bit of context.
And Michael, does this have something to do with the pointing of the boards?
Yes, because you need oversight of the police department.
Okay. That's what I want to hear.
Right, and you're responsible right now, Mayor, for doing those appointments. And the next one that we would see, we would like to see that appointment last longer than less than a month.
Other public comment on this item?
Hi, this is Chris Flowers. I guess I'm actually glad you told me to pull this from consent, because you don't make comment on general public comment, but you can make comment on stuff that's been pulled from consent agenda. And my question is, if we have people that have filled out an application to be on the Community Police Review Board, why aren't we making appointments? So, I mean, that's a big question. We have, I think, at least two vacancies on the Community Police Review Board. And I know there's applications, because the person before me he's mentioned applying before. And also, I don't know if you've thought about this. Why haven't you reached out to him? Like, okay, I can get why you would want him on the board. And maybe there's reasons why you might not want some other people on the board that have applied, but have you reached out to them and said, hey, this is the reason why I don't think you'd be good on the board, but if you change your behavior, then you can be on the board? Like, what if you ask Michael, hey, can you quit going around? Because, well, I can understand why he wouldn't be good on the board, is if he's going around filming the police, like, that's going to be kind of biased if he's on that board. But if you get him to promise to stop going around filming the police, then can he be on the board? Like, you need to seriously be engaging more with the people that say, hey, I want to be on a board. I want to help. Because there are ways in which you can make, in which there's people you might say that they're not capable of being on the board, but I think you could work out differences. And because it's important, because I guess, wasn't it this last police review board meeting's been canceled because they don't have enough members to reach a quorum? So this seems like a pressing issue that we need people on that board. If meetings are being canceled because there aren't enough members, that means you guys are failing at appointing people to the board. Thank you.
No offense to Chris, but the idea that I would surrender my First Amendment right to be on that board is jokeable.
Jeremy Rothko Show, and I agree that the absence of someone for the Community Police Review Board is abhorrent at this point. And it's another demonstration of a basic breakdown of democratic oversight and governance. And I agree with Michael. Like, I agree with what Chris was saying in terms of give people a chance, but I also agree with Michael. The police would do a lot better if we had a community police oversight board that included people who keep a hawk eye on what the police are doing with an audiovisual record. And the fact that the Community Police Review Board, it should be an oversight board. We need actual public oversight. The fact that it's all broken down now, it basically has. And in one individual who uses a camera and speech has done more actual oversight than what's been allowed to happen on that that review board so far. So police, we will have a better community police review board if we actually have oversight from members of the public who see the problems when police are allowed to go into a vacuum of their own creation and are not reminded that they are public servants and they serve we the people.
I hate to interrupt.
Yeah, can't hear.
Up there is cutting out like every other word.
He's on his way out to fix it right now.
How many millions of dollars did we pay for this audio video system?
So, any other public comment on this item? Any other public comment from Zoom?
Stephen Watts.
Hi, thank you. Is the audio functioning, please?
Yes.
Excellent. You know, I didn't know that this was a police review board item. I didn't see it as that, or when I reviewed it, maybe I missed something. I'm happy that it's here. My citizen patriots before me speak so correctly. However, I have to disagree with one of them, and that is, he says, it is not about prostitution, such that the man who films and videos and takes it out to the street has to give that up in order to be a persistent.
Are you talking about border force specifically, or are you just talking about what I'm hearing? You're concerned about
I'm talking about what went on just before me, in addition to the specific appointments that the other gentleman was speaking to. How is mine any different, what I'm talking about? They are speaking directly about the Citizens Review Board, Mayor. Correct?
Go ahead.
I'm asking. I don't want to disturb you.
I wasn't sure
what direction you were going.
Oh, no, I'm
matter?
Just saying that, why? Because I used the word prostitution, I'm saying, to tell that, hey, you can be on the review board provided you do this, that, and the other. Here's a quid pro quo. No, that isn't what a citizen review board is all about. In addition to what my good friend before me was talking about, we need a police citizens review board that controls the police, that tells them what to do, when to do, what to do, if to do. It controls the complaint process. It controls the writing of procedures and policies, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. I understand. It will be a cold day in hell when that happens for our town. Irrespective, thank you for the time. I didn't see it in, I still don't know. I'm looking at it right now.
Mia.
I don't see it. Thank you for your time.
Can you bring it back to the commission? Any discussion on this item? All right.
And Mayor, I'll point out that this is just receiving an appointment. Right. There weren't any mayor appointments on tonight. It's just notice of the county's appointment to one of the
right.
board.
Thank you.
Then why was Chris shut
Thank
down?
You.
It's typically the mayor appointments.
Point of order, though. Why, if that's the case, if you're
Michael, you're
ma'am,
order.
I'm calling a point
yeah.
of order.
Yeah.
In reference to Chris being shut down during public comment, if this was just receiving that appointment, why was it translated to the CPRB and shutting him down?
Michael, I'm going to ask you to step back. You're out of order. Okay.
Right, though.
So we're going to move on to regular agenda item number one. Consider adopting on second and final reading ordinance number 9960, amending city code chapter 10, article 1, relating to the city's policy against discrimination.